So bubble logic is kind of a niche study in electronics. In fact, I tried finding a good tutorial on it, and it doesn't seem anybody actually has one. And it seems like it was pretty much only my college that taught it. I didn't see any evidence that anybody else taught it. But it's still a pretty cool trick to know. And bubble logic is basically the manipulation of bubbles in schematics. And if you're not sure what a bubble is, this is a bubble right here. So anytime you see this little circle on the input or an output of a logic gate, that means that that line is being inverted, and we refer to that as a bubble. And so bubble logic is kind of a trick that we can use to change schematic circuits without actually changing the functionality of a circuit. But one of the key things that one of the key rules that it comes into play with bubble logic is the same thing that comes into play with De Morgan's theorem, is that an AND gate can be replaced with an OR gate if you replace or if you invert all of its inputs and outputs. You've probably seen a couple tutorials cover this, but if it wasn't made explicitly clear, here it is spelled out for you. An AND gate can be replaced with an OR gate with its inputs and outputs inverted. And likewise with an OR gate, you can replace an OR gate with an AND gate with its inputs and outputs inverted. And if you don't believe me, we can actually prove this here. So let's go through the truth table for the AND gate first. So the AND gate is, of course, going to be A and B. Well, here's A and B. So A and B are 0, so that's going to be a 0. B is 0, so that's a 0. A is 0, so that's a 0. A and B are both 1, so that's a 1. And that's the truth table for an AND gate. If we actually go through this truth table here, what this is a combination of the inverse of the sum of the inverse of A and B. So we need to figure out the inverse of A and B first, then the sum of the two, and then the inverse of all that. So the inverse of A, of course, is just not A, so that's going to be 1, 0, 1, 0. Not B is, of course, not B, so 1, 1, 0, 0. So not A or not B is just going to be the ORing of these two values here. So if we take these, both of these are 1s, that's a 1. That's a 1, so that's a 1. A is a 1, so that's a 1. And both of these are 0, so that's a 0. And that is the ORing of those two values. Now we take the opposite of that, which is just inverting all of these, and we get 0, 0, 0, 1. And you'll notice here that both of these results are exactly the same. And we can do the same thing with the OR gates. Like I said, we can replace it with an AND gate and invert all the inputs and outputs, and it's exactly the same thing. We'll prove it. So A or B is going to be 0, 1, 1, 1. We should all be familiar with this. Not A and not B, well, that's going to be 1, 0, 1, 0. And I'm sorry, I forgot to switch colors. 1, 0, 1, 0, and 1, 1, 0, 0. Not A and not B is going to be the ANDing of these two, so both of these are a 1, so that's going to be a 1. In all other instances, there's a 0, so we're going to draw a 0. And then not A and not B, not is just going to be the inverse of all this, so we simply invert the result, 0, 1, 1, 1. And you'll notice once again that A or B, and not A and not B not, is exactly the same. So that in and of itself is nothing new, and it doesn't really explain the whole bubble logic thing all too well. Well, bubble logic, like I said, is the manipulation of a circuit or the changing of a circuit without changing its functionality, and we do that by manipulating bubbles. And so one of the rules that we have when it comes to manipulating bubbles is these bubbles can slide. So if I have a bubble on the output of an AND gate here and a bubble on the output of the AND gate here, I can slide those to just behind the OR gate, and now we have an OR gate with its inputs inverted and its outputs inverted, which means we can actually just replace it with an AND gate. And so that, if we were to actually just eliminate those, is basically just an AND between all four of these inputs to create the result. So this can be used as circuit simplification, but really, Boolean algebra is the best way to do that. You can get a lot better simplification with Boolean algebra. This, like I said, is primarily just for changing the circuit without changing its functionality. And the primary use for this in digital electronics, typically in electronics, we do this to reduce gate variation. So if we have circuits with like three different gates, like here we had two ANDs or two NANDs and a NOR, we could actually change the circuit to just use three AND gates, and it works exactly the same. We can actually use this too in Redstone to simplify our own circuits. Being able to change the position of bubbles is effectively the same thing as changing the position of NOT gates, and that allows us to create smaller and simpler circuits. Now, the other rule to keep in mind when it comes to utilizing bubble logic is when you slide bubbles on a wire, eventually you can actually collide them with other bubbles, so you get these strings of bubbles here. And the general rule of thumb is anytime you see a pair of bubbles, those cancel out. So we can actually draw that as just a plain old wire. So those two bubbles cancel out, and those two bubbles cancel out. So even though we had just an absolute metric load of bubbles all around this buffer, we can end up seeing that those cancel out, so they do nothing, those cancel out, so they do nothing, and we effectively just have a NOT gate. So I'll give you another example here. Let's actually take a well-known circuit here, an exclusive OR circuit, and let's apply some bubble logic. So right off the bat, we can actually see that we have a bubble here and a bubble here. We could shift those over, of course, but let's actually just first replace these with OR gates, and we'll of course need to invert them. Do the same thing over here. And so now we can actually shift these bubbles over just like this, and that cancels them out. So now we have an OR gate with one inverted input and one inverted output, and we could actually shift these over too. In fact, we could probably take this and replace it with an AND gate, invert all of its inputs and outputs, shift those over, and that effectively cancels them out too. And so what we're left with is we're left with basically just a straight connection. Just like that. Kind of clean this up a little bit. And so what we're left with is basically we've eliminated these NOT gates here. We're using just a straight OR gate on both these instances with a single inverter here, and we end up being able to use just a NAND gate here. In fact, I'll even redraw this so it's easier to see. And so what we're left with after changing the logic gates and shifting the bubbles around is we're left with this right here. So instead of having three different logic gates, two NOT gates, two AND gates, and an OR gate. We're left with a NAND gate and this interesting looking OR gate with one of its inputs inverted. And so you might be looking at this going, well, that doesn't really make much sense. It's not really worth doing. It just overcomplicates things. You can't even recognize this as an exclusive OR gate anymore. But this can actually have some uses, and the primary use of this is in electronics. Sometimes you actually have situations where you need more of one gate than another, or you have more of one gate than another. And so doing something like this may actually be helpful because, say, you actually do have quite a number of these particular gates, and you also have quite a number of NAND gates. It actually makes more sense to go for a circuit configuration like this because it utilizes the gates that you already have instead of having to buy new ones. But the same thing can be done with Redstone circuits because doing this actually changes the physical circuit in the game, which allows you to create something that can be, not always, but it can be more compact. Now, another reason why I bring this up is it actually kind of helps you visualize what's going on in a De Morgan theorem type style approach to an expression like this. So De Morgan's theorem states that if I was going to change this expression, I would have to break the bar and change the symbol. So if it's an ORing operation, change it to an AND. If it's AND operation, change it to an OR. And so that effectively turns into A bar and B bar. Now, De Morgan's theorem says that this is the same, but how do we know that? If we actually take a look at this logic gate here, this is the equivalent to this expression here. A plus B not is just an exclusive NOR. But bubble logic says that we can actually replace this with an AND with all of its inputs and outputs inverted. Well, how can we do that? We already have an inverter here. Well, the trick is that we can just kind of slide it away for the time being, just kind of disconnect it from the logic gate. So now we just have a straight up OR gate. And that we can actually change into an AND gate with its inputs and outputs inverted pretty easily. But now we have this dangling OR gate, so we can actually slide that back. It's right here. And as I said before, whenever you have a bubble, or when you have two bubbles paired together like this, they actually cancel out. So the end result is an AND gate with no inverted output and two inverted inputs, which is exactly what we have right here. The inverse of A and the inverse of B. We have the inverse of A and the inverse of B ANDed together. So we can show with bubble logic that De Morgan's theorem is actually correct. And so if you ever have any doubts with De Morgan's theorem, if you're not sure if you're doing it correctly, just kind of revert to bubble logic and kind of work it out. You usually get the answer right pretty consistently.